Hi and welcome back. This is Shreyans Siddharth. So in the previous lesson, I told you to install the compiler as well as the VS Code. So from this video onwards, I will assume that you have got those two softwares installed. So in this lesson, I am going to do some IDE setup. And in case if you are unable to install the compiler as well as the IDE, then please do let me know in the comment box below. I will definitely help you out. So in this lesson, let's do some IDE setup which we are going to use for the entire course. Okay, so what I will do is I am going to launch the VS Code. And by default, your VS Code might have the dark theme. For me, it is the light theme which I have changed later after the installation. So let's close this Get Started wizard and go to File, go to Preferences, and open the settings panel. At the top from the search window, just type theme. So from the theme, you can change your theme of your IDE. Right now I am using the light plus theme, and by default you will get this dark plus theme. So for this course I am going to use this light theme, because I like to use the light theme for the tutorial point of view, but for the working point of view I usually use the dark theme. So you can continue using this dark theme, or you can switch to this light theme. And then close this settings and go to this extensions menu. From here, just type C++. We are going to install some extension which will help us to run the C and C++ programs. So from here, I have already installed this C and C++ extension from this Microsoft. So you can just install this extension from the install button over here. Since I have already installed it, so it is showing uninstall button. And also just below this, you will find C and C++ extension pack. So you can even install this extension. So this extension basically contains a pack of extensions, which you might need later to run the C and C++ programs. You can install it as well. Next, I want you to install one more extension. So just type Code Runner in the search panel. You will get this one with this icon. So just install this extension as well. Once you install all of them, just close everything and close this Visual Studio and restart it. And now I'm going to create the workspace where we are going to put our C and C++ files. So what I will do is, I will just click on this icon over here and click on Open Folder. Then I will select Desktop, and in my desktop I am going to create a new folder. I will call it as My App. So this My App folder is going to behave as a workspace. Just select this folder and it might show you a dialog box to trust this folder. Just click OK. And then within this My App folder, I will click on this icon over here to add a new file. Give the name of the file as myprogram.c. Now remember, .c extension is important over here. Hit enter. Close this getting started prompt. So there we go. We have just created our first C file. And here I am going to type some code. So this is a very basic program written in C. Well, I have written this simple program just to test our IDE settings. And this black dot icon over here is showing us that we have unsaved changes in this file. So either you can save this file using your keyboard buttons such as Ctrl plus S or Command plus S if you are on Mac. Or either you can go to File and click on Save. Now, before we run this program, I want you to make one more changes. Just go to File and then go to Settings. Here from the search panel, just search Run in Terminal. And then scroll down a little bit. Then you will find this checkbox over here, which is related to the Code Runner extension which we just installed. So make sure this checkbox is checked. So this is going to display all the output of the program in the terminal window. Once you do it, just close it, save your program once again, and then on the top right of the screen, you will find this run icon. So we are going to use this icon to run our programs. Just click on it. And here I am getting some error. Well, in case if you are using some antivirus in your system, then the antivirus software is going to deny the permission to run some program in your system. So what I will do is I'm going to open my antivirus, and from here I'm going to go to my real-time scanning. From here I'm going to turn off the real-time scanning. Later you can again enable it. Then now let's run the program again. So here we go, we got hello world in the output console. Nice and simple. So now we are done with our IDE setup. We have installed a few extensions that will help us to run the C program. And also, in case if you find any difficulty running your application, then please check your antivirus. It took me about 2 to 3 hours to figure out what was the issue. So for me, it was the antivirus. And in case if you are unable to run the program still after disabling the real-time protection of antivirus, then please do let me know in the comment section below what's the issue. I will definitely help you out. So from the next lesson onwards, we will start learning the C programming. This is Shreyansh Siddharth, and see you in the next lesson. Bye.